and has made for some very interesting battles, so we could see it come down right to the very end here, as Nilsson is going to see that gap slowly closing and fancy his chances at a run maybe.
Just to update you on a couple of the other battles unfolding, or rather in this instance continuing, Nathan Robinson and Simon Wattman are, although they're both two laps down, are still fighting over P11. Nathan's looking to close down the gap and pass Simon after having led Simon earlier on in the race.
So it's looking pretty good right now for Nilsson, and we can keep going and see what the gap is with Talbot. He's quite a way back at the moment, I believe. And it's 3.8, the gap then currently between Nilsson and Patel, I believe. So it's... But look at that, Talbot all over the back of Strand now. Starting to get very, very tense here with 8 minutes left. Thing is, you don't want to lose it this late on in the race. Both these guys are doing very strong races and come through a lot. And the last thing you want to see them make is a bit of contact and ruin both their races. So while Talbot wants to go on the offensive and make the move, he has to try and play it cool and make sure to bring the car home safely, because if I was in his shoes right now, I would much rather bring home fifth place than fight for fourth and lose it.
Indeed, but in this instance he's actually fighting for fifth place. I'm not sure if that's going to be of a concern to George. I'm not sure how badly he wants the top five. I suspect he'll be wanting to take away as many points as he can from this round. Once again on the previous lap, George ran almost he was in fact over a second faster than Matt Strand, so that battle's really hotting up now.
Yeah, and of course these two very, very established names. So of course after round one, they've had quite strong performances, so let's just see how Talbot can try and pull the gap down. It's just over a second now, and Talbot's just going to... It'd be very hard to judge the situation. Do you A, just lift off and, if there's a mistake, capitalise on it, or B, just go all out for it and try and take as many points as you can?
I think in the instance of George and, for that matter, Anders, who's looking to take the position of Patel, if I'd seen Matt pit early, I would have, going for this second pit stop, I'd already be suspecting that he's short fueled. And if I was Matt, I would have wanted to have taken as little fuel as possible that stop. So I think George has got to put the pressure on Matt, make Matt work as hard as possible. Maybe Matt will feel the need to even turn up the boost again. Either way, Matt might end up running himself out of fuel or making a mistake, in which case George will just be able to cruise past. Same with Anders, who is looking to take away the third place from Mohammed Patel. He's just got to keep the pressure on Mohammed. Mohammed makes a mistake, or perhaps even better, just simply runs out of fuel and Anders can cruise by without having any difficulties.
Yeah, absolutely. It is hot enough. I mean, the gap's strangely actually decreasing between everyone in like the top six. I mean, Enders and Ericsson 6 seconds apart. Then you've got Patel and Nilsson, who could potentially find themselves in a fight. Patel is 30 seconds away, of course, from Ericsson, but you've got Andreas Nilsson 4 seconds clear back from there. And just, of course, behind them, you've got the Talbot and Strand battle, which is separated by a second. So 5 minutes left. It's nowhere near from over.
Just looking at the last lap around, Mohammed has upped his pace a little bit. He was running quite a bit slower, and this time it's Anders who's decided to slow the pace down, so perhaps Anders now also beginning to struggle with fuel. So it looks like it's just George Talbot that's really on the charge now, only about a second off from Matt Strand as they come up for 5 minutes remaining in this race.
Yep, and Talbot showing no signs of holding him back. He wants to take it all, and if he can get it with, you know, time like a minute to go, then it'll be a very heroic action. But of course, it could all go terribly wrong, so that'll be a very, very interesting battle to watch. But Matt Strand now, he can keep his head and hold the line, so he should be okay. I mean, he's just got to think, 4 minutes left, he's driven 56 good minutes, just four more, and he should be all good. That's the mentality he has to have, instead of, oh my god, I can lose it all now, sort of thing. But right now, it's looking in favour of Talbot, though, it has to be said.
The gap in front of the field, Ericsson once again is piling on. The lap times he's pulling out at second a lap over Peter Enders. He's closed the gap to 8.3 seconds now, so it's going to be more and more comfortable for Andreas with every passing minute. And the same for Patel, who's feeling a bit of a gap on Anders Nilsson. Looks like both of them are now struggling with their fuel usage as George brings the gap to just under a second of Mats Rantanen.
Yep, and I mean, we have gone through 57 clear minutes right now, but look at this, Talbot with a great launch off the back, round the outside. That's a very easy position, and Strand had no chance of defending that one, and it's a pure speed advantage that Talbot had there. Was mind-blowing, but Strand's not going to give up too easily. He's got the inside line, as Talbot went a bit wide, and they're almost side by side, but Talbot comes out the victor in that battle for now, as long as he can hold his ground. But I think Strand was defenceless in that move, though. Oh, Talbot's had a bit of a wiggle. Strand, they're trying to cut the inside. He hasn't got the momentum needed to make a move, as he flips the apex very nicely, but that is not going to give him fifth place. I think he may have to settle for sixth at the moment and not risk it. We'll try and push the Talbot for a mistake, but that's a fantastic move from George, as you said.
Yeah, it looks like George is, as we suspected, carrying substantially more fuel than Matt, allowing him to run with a higher boost level, whereas Matt is just really eking out every last drop of fuel in that car. But he is on the offensive here, he's got the draft, he's going to make the pass.
He's going around the outside, might be pushed to the wall, but George plays very nicely. I don't think any of these guys are going to lose it with 2 minutes to go. And it's round the outside then for Strand. He's got the line through the bus stop as they resume back onto the oval. George just doesn't quite have it. So right now, this is getting very, very tense. I'm sure both these drivers will be feeling quite anxious of what to do, because Talbot, for a moment, was the fifth placeholder. You've got Nilsson, who's just around 2 seconds back. And again, look at that, Talbot. The advantage he had there. Sorry for going a bit crazy, but the advantage he had there almost hit the back of Matt Strand again, was purely defenceless. And Strand knows that if he wants to make this stick, he has to try and make the move during the inner circuit, because by the time the race is done, they're not going to finish the lap, but that's how it's overtaking spot out of the window.
Indeed, but at the same time, if I was George, I'd
be... inside. No, beg your pardon, around the outside, as Strand goes up the inside for the move, side by side, and I think Strand may just have it. No, Talbot holds on. Great defending here. I mean, oh, both locked up and still keep out of contact. Wheel to wheel action with a minute 44 left on the clock. This is Clay. Oh, it's big contact. And George still holds on. Oh, this is... oh, I can barely watch this anymore. This is too tense. There's Strand on the throttle, trying to get as much draft as he can to try and take back Talbot. But we know Talbot is quicker through this part of the track, but it's Strand can just stay on the rear wing. There's a car off there. Not too sure who that was.
That's Peter Enders.
Yeah, Peter Enders, his second place now, he's head up to third. But right now, that means that this battle is for fourth place as they'll resume onto the oval. And can Strand get a run? He's gone a bit lowering over the curb, and I think that's given power with the position. So carnage during the last couple laps there, because 57 seconds to go, and Peter Enders' race has ended, I think.
Indeed, I
stop it.
Yeah, I was just trying to see that Matt Strand was looking to do what I was going to say he should do, which is hold back off George, pass him on the exit of the bus stop. Otherwise, George would just pass him on this final lap for the position, and see how it plays out here. George is going to have to go really defensive. He's going to want to hold on to this position as we come on the final lap.
Strand's got the inside. That's a daring move. And Talbot's given way. Is he going to try and duck underneath? Yes, he does. Talbot's gone a bit wide, though. Oh no, it's Strand even. I'm sorry, but Strand is holding on the position at the moment. This is it, 18 seconds left. This is the final lap. And Talbot is either going to A, risk it all, or B, just sell for fifth. And if I was him, I'd just sell for fifth right now. But Ericsson is your race winner, though. Fantastic drive by him. As he said, he's done a brilliant job after coming after all tons of pressure, that managed to claim the victory. So congratulations to him, and that's going to help his title bid. It looks like it's going to be Mohamed Patel, who's in second, just in front of Nilsson. Look at the gap there. That's like
Nilsson's front. Just taking the position off Mohamed. Let's see if we can get you to that battle now. Here we are with Mohamed in a really tight battle here on the final lap now.
Are they on the final lap, or have they finished?
This is the final lap. This is right. The final lap.
So one last opportunity for Patel, one last opportunity for Talbot. These two guys facing, of course, Nilsson and Strand. Four guys, four positions, four of the top four as well. So it's very, very tense moments here around the inner circuit. Patel has to keep his nerve. Nilsson isn't going to want to sacrifice that position anytime soon. He'll be straight on the back of Patel if he can.
If I was Patel in this situation, I'd be tempted to let Nilsson take me
into the bus stop and then get the drive. Got a bit too deep. Nilsson's got the drive, I think, as they head onto the oval section of Daytona. Once again, Daytona never fails to live up to the reputation and produce a fantastic race. It's going to come down to the wire, side by side. Nilsson, it's got it, surely, around the back stretch. But Ericsson's your winner, and he's done a fantastic job. But Patel, as they go through the bus stop, going to need to try and get as big of an advantage as he can. Doesn't cut the corner there, so now he needs to try and get a drive. I think Nilsson's going to take P4, and it's been very well contested right down to the wire. And I don't know, he's got a drive, it's not enough, surely. He goes, he's done it? Gonna still go, has he got the drive?
He might make it.
And I think Nilsson's done it. Eyes contact! But I think that was Nilsson who won it. Patel will be very disheartened with that. As you can see, into the wall.
Confirmation that Nilsson definitely got that.
Albert is, I think he's dropped quite away now. Has he got in front?
No, he was quite a bit off Matt Strand as they went into the end of that lap.
So it came down to the very wire in the end, but it was Ericsson who was your race winner from Andreas Nilsson under the most tense circumstances I've seen in quite a while in sim racing. It came down to the very line, they were side by side, it was a photo finish. Congratulations to Andreas Nilsson. We said it would be close and it lived up to the reputation, but Ericsson has driven a fantastic race and praise to him, that's going to very help his championship out quite a lot. So fourth place Strand, fifth was Talbot, and you can see Talbot off track there. So it's been a fantastic race. So who's your driver of the day, George? I meant Rich, sorry.
Hard to say, Andreas. Just to give you an update, Peter Enders, who dropped out on lap 36, three laps before the end, he had an engine failure. But as for driver of the day, hard to say. Andreas Ericsson drove an absolutely solid race. I'd have to hand it to, as much as it pains me to say this, Mohamed Patel, who drove a really strong race, coped with the pressure well earlier on, had a really fantastic fight, and dealt with his issues earlier on and managed to get that podium position. So our top three, Andreas Ericsson wins, Anders Nilsson second, and Mohamed Patel in third place.
And we actually have our race winner with us. So Andreas Ericsson, firstly, congratulations on the win. How does it feel right now?
Feels pretty good. First race in this league, so one race, one win. Can't be better than that.
And so how did it feel towards the end? I mean, of course, you came under a bit of pressure, but handled it very well. So just go through a quick run through of your race for us.
Yes, start was good. You always worried on this track with the draft. And I got separation pretty early, so I was pretty confident, you know, things were going pretty well, but Enders was catching me and keeping up with me, and at the end of the first stint, I was saving a bit of fuel, so I let him through. I was hoping to get a bit more pace on the second stint. When I came out, I had lost about 4 seconds, but managed to make that up, and then I was just going to them, trying not to spin. It's a really tough track, this one, because you're jumping around. I think everyone was taking it very easy. And then I think it was 5 laps from the end. Clark blew his engine, and it was in the middle. And I was going low, and then he turned down towards the apron, and also taken out there, but managed to survive. That's basically it.
Yep. So where do you think you see yourself in the championship battle? Can you see yourself winning it this year?
Yeah, maybe. You know, if I continue to race here and things are going good, there's no reason why not. I hope. There's a lot of fast guys, so if they split in some time to practice and things like that, it's going to be very tough.
Well, thanks for your time. I think we'll let you go and have a beer maybe and just chill out for a bit and celebrate your win. So congratulations, Andreas, and I'm sure we'll see you very soon for round three.
Okay, and we have Anders Nilsson joining us in the booth. Anders, a bit of a slow start to that race, but began to claw your way back up through the field, and then a rather triumphant battle with Muhammad as you came across the line there.
That was epic. Yeah, the first stint I actually saved both fuel and engine, actually, and I got a lap extra than Muhammad, and I think that was the difference, because I was running very high boost at the end of the race, and I was catching him, and my engine was actually dropping faster than the fuel, so I was a bit worried. But the last lap was boost 5 just to catch him and pass him.
I mean, obviously you started, you know, quite in a healthy position, so how did your race go then? Like, what were your opinions on it?
In the beginning, the tempo was too high for me, and especially on the boost that I was running, I felt like a sitting duck there in the beginning. So it was hectic.
So, same question as we asked the race winner, but where do you see yourself in the championship fight? Can you still win it?
I'm going to try. Can't let Andreas win it without a fight.
All right, well done, and congratulations on your very, fantastic finish. It came right down to the wire. So, again, we'll let you go and chill out for a bit, and we'll see you for round 3. So, also in the booth, we've got George Talbot, and George, your race came almost to blows in the final stint, so talk us through that.
Yeah, I did put in enough practice today. It was very, very slow. I pretty much was by myself. Like, Timu had some issues, and Nick had to pit again. But yeah, I think Matt Strand was playing some mind games with me and wanted to have a bit of a race, so he waited up for me, and I put the boost up to 5 and then didn't have enough fuel, so I was crawling around at the end. But yeah, it was quite good fun. Nice to see a decent amount of finishes this time, but just happy to make it to the end.
So what actually happened at the start there? Because I think there was quite a bit of chaos going on, so what was your take on all of that towards the start of the race?
Well, I think the actual start wasn't too bad. Everyone seemed to make it through from what I could see, but I think Nick Phillips came in a bit hot into turn 2 and hit the side of my car, but it wasn't too bad. Just wanted to take it easy, but I was expecting a big crash into turn 1, but it seemed to be all right. I'm not sure. Maybe there was something I missed.
Okay, in the other half of George's battle, Matt Strand also joins us in the booth. Matt, we were enjoying your race. It was a very feisty one in the early portion before your first stop, and then we were a little bit surprised when you came in for your second stop. Was that an intentional strategy or a miscalculation?
No, that was more of we can't count in our pits kind of thing. I was trying to go for a one stop. It just didn't work out with the calculator.
Ah, these things happen. it certainly played out and gave us something to talk about. After you came out there, we were a little bit worried that the gap was never going to come down and that maybe you were saving a little bit more fuel. It was interesting to see how it panned out.
Yeah, I mean, I had plenty of fuel at the end because I forgot to map a button to go through and change the pit strategy and all that. So every time I pitted, they only put in 90 liters. So I ended up finishing the race with, I think, 40 liters in the car. So it was slowing me way down with George running around on fumes, and he managed to run up to my gearbox, and we had a scrap, and then I guess he realized he had to do another lap, so he had to back it way down again.
Yeah, so, of course, heading into round 3, what are your opinions on the next circuit?
What's the next circuit,
Africa? Road America, allegedly.
So, yeah, I think it's Road America.
Well, allegedly, then, I'd have to say I'm a big fan. I love Road America. I've always had decent results there, so looking forward to it.
Awesome, so we will see you very shortly then. So I think that just about rounds it up, if I'm not mistaken.
We have one driver left. I'm not sure if Mark wants to talk about his rather dismal display this evening.
Mark, dragged in here. I got told I was supposed to come in and speak to you.
There were some interesting moments, some really feisty driving at the beginning of the race, but it all began to dissolve rather rapidly after about 10, 15 minutes.
Yeah, it started well. It got through the first corner cleanly. I think I was 3 wide with Matt and Andreas, or maybe Anders. Then it was one spin kind of put me off. Went into first gear in the first corner, which was a big mistake. I tried to get out, went on the grass, and yeah, it was fun picking my way back through the field, but the finisher was coming up the inside of Timo as we were back on the banking. He had a moment, and he just tapped me, and that sort of bent my steering arm a tad. So I was a bit down on top speed, but down on downforce. But, I mean, I'm glad I finished. That's all I wanted to do was just finish, so I'm glad I've done that.
I think that, does that wrap it up for us then?
I believe so. So from me and Rich, actually got your name right that time, so from us here at Daytona, it's been a superb race and it's been a pleasure to commentate, and I hope I'll have the opportunity again. So until next time, I'm Liam Jenkins, and from Rich as well, we hope you have a very